Your life is your creation. December 13, 2014. Greetings, dear ones. As you awaken to the truth that you are the one who creates your world, that you are the one who creates your life, you will no doubt find that your attention will be drawn to new things. What used to satisfy and interest you will shift. This is the process of awakening. It is quite simply the conscious realization that you are more than what you have been previously led to or allowed to believe. It is literally waking up to the fact that you are the one who is responsible for the contents of your life and in turn the world. It is the understanding that nothing outside of you can ever change you or save you. The only things that truly belong to you are the things that you discover for yourself. All else is but illusion. Many of you long for a world that is peaceful and beautiful. A world full of people who are happy and cared for and where all beings have access to the basics of what they need to live a life that is fulfilled. This is a noble vision indeed. However, there is nothing that can occur for the collective that has not first occurred within the individual. For the world to be at peace, peace must first occur in the hearts of each person that lives upon it. A person who does not have the basic understanding of how to take care of themselves can never effectively care for another. We understand that as more of you wake up, you will no doubt be quite passionate about that which you feel is unfair or unjust. This is a very powerful position to be in. We encourage you to first begin to create fairness and justice in your own lives before trying to create them in the world at large. You see, the vibration on your planet is one that is collective. When enough people begin to exercise their personal power to create a life that is born from truth and love, it will inevitably shift the collective vibration to one of truth and love. As above, so below. What lies within, lies without. These phrases are more than just metaphors. They are truth. Understand that each and every one of you are responsible for the fabric of your own individual lives. There is nothing that you can do for another that you have not first done for yourself. We are not saying that you should not care for or help another. Yet, it is important to know that you cannot override your own vibration. If you are not coming from a place of love and acceptance for who you are, then you cannot do the same for another. Be unconditionally loving with yourself first, and then unconditional love will flower within you. You are not here to fix anyone. You are not here to change anyone. You are here to live through the clarity of your example as someone who stands in their own individual power. Can you not see that when all beings in a group or a society or on a planet stand firm in the power of their own truth, that it creates a united front that nothing can withstand? Trust that everyone is undergoing what they need to undergo for the growth and evolution of their own soul. You have nothing of value to share with others if you yourself are depleted. It is not selfish to ensure that you are strong and healthy first before you begin to create external change. External change always begins internally. Your world always mirrors what is going on internally for the collective. Right now you see turmoil and chaos because many are waking up to the fact that there is nothing outside of them that will save them. That they must stand up for themselves first. True power lies in a group of individuals who come together to say we are united in the truth of who we are. Your offering to the world is the love you share, your creation is your life. All that you do, feel, think, and act upon is part of your creation. So many of you ask, am I on my path? What is it that I am to do with my life? We say to you quite simply, if you are alive, then you are on your path. Once you begin to see that the small, seemingly meaningless day-to-day actions are your life. That each now moment is your life. That nothing external is going to come down, tap you on the shoulder and say, okay, now you can begin to live, then you begin to realize the power of the now moment. Once you acknowledge that you are on your path right now, then you can begin to consciously take an active role in creating what you want for yourself. If you do not like the way you feel, choose a new feeling. If you do not like the thoughts in your mind, then choose new thoughts. If you do not like what you see on the news and read in the papers, then turn off the TV, fold up the newspaper, and begin to cultivate in yourself what you wish to see in the world. There are countless tools and teachers and books and information out there, all with the intention of helping you to make a better life for yourself. Find what resonates with you as truth and begin. We are not here to tell you what is right and what is wrong. We are simply stating that there is no someday, there is only now. The tools to build that which you desire are at your feet. They have always been available to you. You live in a time where information is shared literally at the speed of light. You live in an age where information is light. However, tools and ideas and information are useless if they are not used to consciously and deliberately create that which you desire to see. Let your intention be to create a world that mirrors your internal state. When you take responsibility for what you have going on internally and acknowledge that your internal landscape is your offering to the world, it immediately becomes very clear what your work is. Do you want to see what is currently in your heart and mind magnified on a global scale? If the answer is no, then you know exactly what must be done internally now. Begin, dear ones. Begin. We have said it before and it bears repeating. You are the one you have been waiting for. In love and light we leave you. Rejoice. The Lighted Ones. Channeled by Andrew Martin. www.thelightedones.com